Good morning. My name is Lane Kranz, and I'm a volunteer on the stewardship team at Virginia-Highland Church. And today I'm so excited to share with you a new project that we're kicking off. This is the first of a four-part video series taking a look behind the scenes at Virginia-Highland Church. You know, it's an amazing journey and an amazing place that we're all on together. And I'm excited to help you meet a few people and perhaps learn a few things about this amazing place that you didn't know. There's actually three pillars to our success as a church. You might even consider this to be our secret sauce. So those pillars are attendance, and thank you for being here today, by the way. The second is participation, and the third is giving. We're gonna take a look at each of these in depth, and we're gonna meet some amazing people along the way. All right, so I'm here with Gary Montgomery, who is a longtime member of Virginia-Highland Church and one of our most outstanding volunteers. And Gary is a member of the Parish Council, and part of his duties in that volunteer job on the Parish Council is taking care of the church. So Gary, thank you so much for everything you do for the church. You are just amazing. Can you tell us a little bit this morning about what are some projects that have recently been completed at the church due 100% due to people giving to Virginia-Highland Church?
Well, obviously the first one I can think of is our lift project, which has taken many months longer than we thought it would take. It has just completed. We've worked out the final bugs, and actually this is the first Sunday I can tell you that it's worked and it hasn't quit on us. So I'm pretty confident now we're going to have a good road ahead. Right?
So obviously a building of this age and of this type needs a lot of TLC.
Yes.
So what are some upcoming things that we know we need some help on, that we need some work on?
Well, one of the projects we're working on right now is the bathroom downstairs, which currently is the ladies' bathroom. We want to convert that into an accessibility bathroom where folks with wheelchairs and walkers and so forth can get in and use the facilities better.
An accessible bathroom,
right,
definitely is an excellent project, and we need everyone's help to make that happen. How about the air conditioners? I hear the air conditioners are pretty famous at this church.
When we're talking about money, now we've got a real project on our hands. Our air conditioning for the sanctuary was put in back in 2012. And so that was six brand new Carrier air conditioning units, which were up in the attic, quite frankly, on top of the inside the roof. But there are eight other units that take care of the rest of the church, all the other office space and that kind of thing, the rents that we, rooms that we rent out. So there are four units on the ground and four units on the roof. And these things, I believe, are like 1970 vintage or maybe early 80s. They're very old. The contractors who've come out to talk about these have told us they're very surprised they're still running.
Tell us, when people donate money to the church, they pass the offering tray down the rows. Part of that money obviously goes to church salaries and to church expenses, and these are the exact type of expenses we're talking about. Our new lift, an accessible bathroom,
right,
and an upcoming project on the air conditioning. So there's always things that need to be done. Gary, are you on the church payroll?
No, sir.
It's you're just a volunteer,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
And so am I. And this is how our church works. It's volunteering, and we have three pillars to our success, which is volunteering, participating, and giving. And giving in terms of your time, and giving in terms of your donations. This is how all of this comes together, and this is how our church makes things work.
Hi, I'm Nancy. I'm a physician, and I come to Virginia Highlands Church because they walk the walk and talk the talk and teach us to live the way Jesus did.
My name is Jane. I'm a retired nurse, and what drew me to Virginia Highland Church is the commitment to social justice. We do what we say.
My name is Patrick. I'm a kindergarten teacher full-time during the week. On the Sundays, I'm at Virginia Highland Church. I play the piano. I volunteer with the homeless ministry, and I help out a dear friend that's elderly. And there are I just get so much enjoyment out of it, because seeing others that need your help is a great gift.
Why do I volunteer? I guess because I fell in love with this church. I came here, I was invited here, I was invited several times, because I don't do church. Even though I'm a pastor, I don't do church. But I finally came, and I came for choir rehearsal. That's what drew me. And I fell in love with the people at rehearsal, and they asked me, are you going to come Sunday? And I said, yeah. So my first volunteer effort was actually in the choir, and that was my first Sunday at the church. And I've come ever since, because it's just, I don't know, it feels as if, and I'm not going to say as if, it's genuine. And it should be that way, I think, always in church, but I think many people know it doesn't feel that way. And here it does feel that way.
I do volunteer, and part of the reason is the passion for social justice that this congregation has. I have a passion about social justice as well, and about being God's hands and feet in the world. And I feel like this congregation is committed to that, and it's, you know, it's fun. There's so many wonderful, wonderful people that I've gotten to know because I was volunteering.
Okay. So, good morning, and can you just tell us a little bit about why you come to Virginia Highland Church?
We attended Virginia Highlands Church today because this church is so open to more. It welcomes all people, all denominations, all ethnicities, and the congregation is loving. The pastor always has something that is so poignant to what's going on today. And so we wanted to come in today and also to honor one of our late friends who was a member here. And unfortunately, we didn't get the chance to attend with him, but he's here in spirit. So it was a wonderful experience today. Once again, our pastor was right on board.